So this is going to be a key concept for being able to develop an answer to questions like that. And it's the notion of epsilon exhaustion, which sounds kind of tiring.
I know I'm epsilon exhausted right now.
Yeah, me too. So what we mean by this is, well, here's a definition. So a version space that's derived from a particular sample is considered epsilon exhausted if and only if, for all the hypotheses that are in that version space, they have low error, right? So if we can do this, then your algorithm is going to work, right, Charles? Your algorithm says, at that point, choose any of the hypotheses in your hypothesis set, and you're going to be fine. You're going to have low error.
Sure.
And if you don't do this, then your algorithm is going to be in trouble because you're going to uniformly at random choose one of the hypotheses, and it has a chance of being wrong. And it could be a fairly high chance if there's, say there's only two hypotheses left in the version space. One is right, and one has high error, and one has low error. We really have to make sure that the only things left in the version space have low error.
Okay, that makes sense. That makes sense.
All right, so we're going to have to develop a little bit of theory to figure out when that occurs, but this is a really key concept.
Okay. So I guess if I was trying to put this in English, just to make certain I understand it, what you're saying is something is epsilon exhausted. A version space is epsilon exhausted exactly in the case when everything that you might possibly choose has an error less than epsilon.
Sure.
Period. And so if there's anything in there that has error greater than epsilon, then it's not epsilon exhausted.
Right. It's still epsilon energized.
Right. That makes a lot of sense. Epsilon energized. That's a pretty good name for a band. Okay.